And I wanted to show you something that might be helpful in terms of having your shopping under control this Christmas season. So I wanted to show you how shopping malls work, because they have a particular layout that is enticing for consumers to spend your money. So it isn't they don't just put all the stuff out there, but there's a lot of psychology that goes into the design of a store. So if you have a look at this high-end store that I'm in at the moment, you'll see that all the fragrances are there as soon as you come into the store. And they're designed to elicit all the senses, all your responses that you might have. So you'll find that the fragrances are always there. And usually there will be a shop assistant awaiting, you can see them in the background, awaiting to spray you with some sort of gorgeous fragrance. And then you've got these little, see if I can do it. Whoops, don't know if you can see it here. But anyway, there's lots of smelly things here designed to encourage you to engage all of your senses. And then as we go around, you'll see the lighting in this store is extraordinary. You'll have all the designer stuff around to encourage you to draw you in and to encourage you to spend. Then they'll have all the designer stuff on the side, and then, see if I can see it behind me, you can see all the designer stuff there. And then they'll have this slightly less expensive stuff, which is things like the watches. I don't know if you can see them behind me. Maybe not. But I wanted to show you a technique that you can use to help you avoid the temptations when you are in a shopping mall. We can't spend our whole lives never going to a mall, and it's learning to manage the temptations when we're here that's going to set you forward. And being noticing that your self-worth shouldn't be attached to the things that you own. So as we come up, we're coming up to the men's section here, and also to the crockery and cutlery and all those kinds of bits and pieces. So really, one of the techniques that you can do is to detach your self-esteem from the things that we desire and believe that we'll be better people or we'll be better off if we have these. So we're in the linen section now, and you can see there's some beautifully made beds over here, and some all sorts of things that we may don't necessarily need, but the store is designed to entice you to buy those things. And it's because of the unconscious thinking, the script that we have running in the background, that tells us that we need this. Now look at this gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous bed. I don't know if you can see it, beautifully made. It's absolutely stunning. It's all very expensive and very beautiful to look at. But when we get our self-esteem caught up in having material things, it's very hard to walk past them, like walk past all these chocolates and things that I can believe very easily that I need these things for Christmas. I want these things. And that's where desire comes in. And the stores are all set up and using very expensive psychologists to help to design it in a way that increases your likelihood of buying what you need. So I've come to the section that I was wanting to find my way to, so show you a technique on how to avoid buying things just because you have that instant connection with it and want to buy it straight away. So I'm making my way around. I saw something that I thought I'd quite like to show you because it's so beautiful. And I thought, I want it. And then I took a deep breath and I really connected with what I was looking at to see if I really did want it. So I'm going to show it to you, and I'm sure a lot of you might enjoy this as well. Okay, so here it is. Here is a beautiful tea set. It's a Royal Albert, and I'll just zoom in on the price. Look at that. Okay, it's $399. For how many cups? 5 cups. And then we've got a beautiful cake stand, which is $300. So it's for seven, these two things here, $700 for 5 cups and a tea stand. And let's see if I can flip it back. Okay, so there we have our $700 item. And each of these cups, see if I can show you, and plates are $200. So really just looking at it and breathing, taking a moment. And it's the trick is to reconnect the other part of your neural pathways, the new habit that doesn't automatically go look, desire, want, have. So it's a pathway that's already extremely well established, especially if you've been shopping as a hobby, as a comfort feature in your life. As soon as you see something beautiful, like, you know, five cups for $400, it's automatic. And the technique I want to show you is just to look at it and enjoy it, and without the thought, I need to own it. I don't need to take it away with me. I don't need to have this in my house. If I really want it, I can take a photo of it and I can go and think about it. I can come back tomorrow. I can come back next week and I can connect in with, do I really, really want to spend $400 on 5 cups? I connect with the reality of what this actually means. In the moment right now, look at this gorgeous shop I'm in. It's absolutely stunning, and there are some very, very beautiful people doing very, very beautiful things. Everyone's wandering around looking happy, and I want to associate with that. I want to associate with the bling, with the shiny, with the happy. And so it's really easy to just go, okay, let's take it to the counter and bring it in. But at the same time, I also know what I want for myself long term. And it's bringing the shiny of tomorrow, the one that will wake up tomorrow morning and go, holy moly, I spent $400 on cups, 5 cups to have a cup of tea. My husband would say, does it taste any different? Well, probably not, but I like to imagine that they do. But really, it's just noticing what I'm actually doing. And the key tip is to breathe. Number one is to breathe, look at the item, notice, take some deep breath and just look at the item and really notice the desire that rises up in you, that desire that says, I want it and I need it. And really breathe into it and just notice the thoughts that are running through my mind. And to be able to notice it and to question them, is it true that I really want this item? And it's a yes or a no. Then if it's a yes, ask yourself, can I absolutely know that I want this item? And again, you might say, yes, I definitely need 5 cups for $400. And then how do I react? Question 3 from the units. How do I react when I believe the thought, I want this? And question 4, who would I be without the thought? Who would I be in this moment looking at these beautiful cups and plates and etc. without the thought, I want to own it, that I need it? Well, I would move on to the next thing. I'd move on to the next item that I'm looking at or enjoying. So I would just move on and I would just walk away like I'm walking away now, because I'm no longer attached to the thought that I need it or that I want it. And so I can walk around this beautiful, beautiful shopping mall. If you can change the where your focus is, you can actually walk away. You can just walk away and think to yourself, if I really want it tomorrow, if it's in my budget to spend $400 on 5 cups, then I can come back. And I can come back knowing it's in my budget, it's part of my long-term goal, is to have nice things that I can afford, and I walk away. I don't need to be drinking out of a $100 cup to feel special. I don't need the stuff to know that I'm good enough. I don't need the bling items to feel that I'm lovable just the way that I am. And I can move on to the next door, or I can move on to something else or do something else. Ultimately, I guess it's really about connecting with your self-worth. And once I'm connected with myself, I can actually wander around a shopping mall and enjoy it for what it is. I can think, right, this year, Christmas, we're spending $100 on each child, or $200, whatever you've decided in your family. I am back in the noisy bit now. And you can wander around a shopping mall and really just enjoy it, and not have to stay in the car and feel that if I go in there, I cannot control myself. And that may be an initial strategy you put in place to make sure that you don't let go. But really, it's really about feeling your feelings and getting connected. I'm going to come back in here because it was quieter in here. Feeling your feelings and noticing, am I trying to anesthetize myself by going shopping? What feelings am I trying to avoid? And I hope you'll try this technique next time you need to go to the mall, to go and look, connect with something that you really like the look of, like the beauty of, and I encourage you to take a photo of it, and to take a photo and just enjoy its beauty without needing to own it, without needing to have it with you.